वेलकम टू एस वी यूनियन हाई स्कूल एंड जूनियर कॉलेज।
वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद अ न्यू चैप्टर फ्रॉम योर मैथमेटिक्स एंड स्टैटिस्टिक्स पेपर 2, दैट इज नेम्ड एज डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन। नाउ ऑलरेडी यू हैव स्टडीड डिफरेंशिएशन एंड इंटीग्रेशन इन योर प्रीवियस चैप्टर्स। द नेक्स्ट वी विल स्टार्ट विद डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन। Now, what is the differential equation? See, here I have written the definition. Equation which contains the derivative of a function is called as differential equation. So, all of you all know what is an equation. Now, when it comes to differential equation, means what? Differential indicates that the equation contains derivative of a given function. Okay? Now, I have taken few examples here. Like dy by dx is equal to cos x. This becomes an example of a differential equation. It is an equation which consists of derivative of a function dy by dx. Now look at next example. I have taken d square y upon dx square plus k square into y is equal to 0. So this is also an equation and it consists of second order derivative of a function. Therefore this is also called as a differential equation. Now one more example, see here, d square y upon dt square whole square plus d square x upon dt square is equal to x. Here you can see y is a function of t and x is a function of t, and this equation consists of derivative of the given functions. Yes, so this is also an example of a differential equation. See one more example here, d cube y upon dx square plus x into dy by dx minus 4xy is equal to 0. So again it is a differential equation. Because this equation consists of derivative of the function y with respect to x, here you have order 3 derivative, here order 1 derivative. So this equation consists derivative of the given functions. Hence these all are examples of differential equations. Yes, clear? Now we have to see next what is order of differential equations. Now in derivatives, that is differentiation, you have already studied first order derivative, second order, third order, nth order. So these order derivatives are there. So what will be the order of the differential equation? The highest order of the derivative appearing in the equation is called as the order of the differential equation. So in the equation, you will have first order derivative, or you may have first as well as second order derivative, you may have third order derivative also. So which is the highest order present in that equation, that becomes your order of the differential equation. Now in this example, if we want, we can see. See, if you look at this equation, what is the order of this differential equation? Only one derivative exists and order of this derivative is 1. So order of this differential equation will be 1. Now if you go to this example, if you look at this example, in this example you have one derivative here. And what is the order of this highest derivative? It is 2. So order of this differential equation will be 2. Now move to the next differential equation. Now in this, d square y upon dt square whole square, d square x upon dt square is equal to x. So what is the highest order? Now y function with respect to t order is 2. X function with respect to t order is 2. That means the highest order derivative which appears in this equation is 2. Therefore order of this equation will also become 2. Now move to this example. See here you have two derivatives. One is order 3 and one is order 1. So what is the highest order? It is 3. Yes? So what will be the order of this differential equation? It will be 3. So in the equation, the highest order of derivative which exists, that becomes your order of the differential equation. Okay? Clear? The next definition is degree of differential equation. Now, you have already studied degree of equations. Now, in differential equation, what will be the degree? The power of highest order derivative present in the equation. Now highest order means becomes your order of the differential equation. Now what is the power of that highest order? That becomes your degree of the differential equation. Here only one derivative. What is the power of this derivative? It is 1. That means degree of this differential equation is 1. Now here, if you look, what is the highest order derivative? 2. What is the power of this highest order derivative? 1. That means degree of this differential equation is also 1. Now if you look at here, for 1 order 2, the power is 2. So what will become the degree of this differential equation? The degree of this differential equation will become 2. Yes? Now move here. Now if you see, we found out order of differential equation is this. So for this only you have to look the power. What is the power? 1. That means the order of differential, or degree of differential equation is 1. So first always you see what is the order of the differential equation and what is the power, highest order, what is the power of that value, that differential, you have to see and accordingly you have to 1, 1, 2 and here also the degree will become 2. Understood what is the degree? You just have to see the highest order derivative and what is the power, that becomes your degree. Now one note I have written here, you will read that note first. To find degree, we need to have positive integer as the index of each derivative. So this is note what you have to remember. Now whenever you have to find degree, degree means what? The highest order power you are finding. Now whenever you have to find the degree, you have to check that you have a positive integer as the index of each derivative. Now suppose in this example, if I had the power of this derivative as half, then I cannot find the degree of the given differential equation. What should be your power of each derivative? It should be a positive integer. That is the index of each derivative which exists in the differential equation, the power should be positive integer. If it is not a positive integer, you have to simplify that differential equation and bring to a form where power of each derivative becomes a positive integer. You all are understanding what we have to do? If the power is negative fraction or it is a fraction or it is a negative integer, then what you have to do is, if possible, you have to simplify that differential equation and bring that differential equation to a form so that each index of each derivative, it will be a positive integer. So after simplifying, then only you can write the degree of the given differential equation. Okay? So now after studying the definition of order and degree of differential equation, let us take few examples and find the order and degree of the following differential equation. So look at the first example. What it is given? D square y upon dx square plus x into dy by dx plus y is equal to 2 sin x. If you look at the whole equation, wherever derivative is there, the power is positive index. Okay? Then second thing, the whole equation is expressed as a polynomial equation in the derivative. So this is a proper equation. Here you need not simplify anything. So directly you can find the order and degree. Now what is the highest order in this equation? The highest order is 2. So order of this differential equation will become 2. Then you have to see what is the power of highest order derivative. You can see the power is 1. So degree of this differential equation is 1. So order 2 and degree 1. See, whenever you look at the equation, first you have to see that the equation is a polynomial equation in the derivative of the given function. And secondly, the power of any of the differentiation, the derivative is not negative integer or a fraction. Otherwise you have to simplify the equation. Okay? The next equation, y. It is the third order derivative. You know this symbol also. Triple line means what this is? Third order derivative to the power 2 plus 3 second order derivative plus 3x into y raised to first order derivative plus 5y is equal to 0. Now if you look at this equation, again it is a proper polynomial equation in the derivative. Then powers of the derivatives are also positive integers. So this is a clear differential equation, no need to simplify it. So what will be the order? The highest order is 3. So order of this differential equation is 3. And what is the power of highest order? It is 2. That means the degree of this differential equation is 2. Okay? So order 3 and degree 2. Yes. Now look at the next example. Now in this example, d square y upon dt square plus dy upon dx whole square plus 7x plus 5 is equal to 0. Again, a clear polynomial equation in derivative. Then powers are also positive integer. What is the highest order derivative? Clearly, we can see it is 2. So, order will be 2. Then next, what is the power of highest order? It is 1. So, degree will be 1. So, don't get confused here. Your power is 2. So, your degree does not mean 2. We have to see the degree of highest order derivative. Here, the order is 1. The highest order is 2. You have to see the power of this highest order. So, it is 1. So, degree will be equal to 1. Now, next example, d square y upon dx square whole square plus cos of dy by dx is equal to 0. If you look at this equation, here you can see this term. It is cos of dy by dx. That means this equation is not expressed as a polynomial equation in the derivative. The derivative is angle of this cos. Cos of dy by dx. That means you cannot express this equation as a polynomial equation in derivative. So what happens here? The degree becomes not defined. And the order is 2. Here you can see highest order derivative is 2. So order remains 2, but degree is not defined. The reason being that it cannot be expressed as a polynomial equation in the derivative. Okay? The next example also you can see e raised to dy by dx plus dy by dx is equal to 1. If you look at here, highest order is 1, so order will become 1. But again this equation, it cannot be expressed as a polynomial equation in the derivative, therefore degree is again not defined. So understood these examples? So when you have 4 examples, 3 examples what we have taken, they are clear polynomial equations in derivative and the powers are also positive integers. So directly we can write the order and degree of this equation. But if you look at these two examples, in these two examples degree is not defined because you cannot express the equation in the form of polynomial equation in the derivative. Okay? Now we will see the next example. Here you can see dy by dx is equal to 2 sin x plus 3 upon dy by dx. Now clearly you can see we can simplify this equation. We can take this numerator this way. What it will become? Will become dy by dx whole square is equal to 2 sin x plus 3. So this becomes the simplified form of this equation. Now you can write the order and degree of this equation. So what is the order? See, order, first order derivative is only present. So order will become 1. And what will be degree of this equation? What is the power of highest order? It is 2. So degree becomes 2. So first we a little bit simplified it and then we found out the order and degree of the differential equation. Yes? Now in this example, what is the example? Cube root of 1 plus dy by dx whole square is equal to d square y upon dx square. Again you can see this is cube root, means power is 1 by 3. That means it is a fraction. So we need to simplify. What is meaning of this? 1 plus dy upon dx whole square to the power 1 upon 3. It is equal to d square y upon dx square. So what we need to do here, take cube on both sides, cube both the sides. So what is going to happen here, what this equation will become? So this will become 1 plus dy upon dx whole square. 1 by 3 into 3 is equal to d square y upon dx square whole cube. So this 3 gets cancelled here. So simply your equation remains 1 plus dy upon dx whole square is equal to d square y upon dx square whole cube. So what is the order of this equation? So order and degree. What is the highest order here? The highest order is 2, mentioned here, each power is a positive index, and then we can write the order and degree. So order, highest order is 2 and the power is 3. So order 2 and power 3. Now next examples. Now you are going to see d square y upon dx square plus dy by dx plus x, it is equal to root of 1 plus d cube y upon dx cube. Now again here you can see highest order is 3, you can see easily in the equation, but here it is square root. So what means it? It is to the power half. That means we have to remove this power. So what we have to do here? Square both sides. So what it will become? D square y upon dx square plus dy upon dx plus x whole square. And when you square this side, root sign will go. So this becomes the simplified form of this equation. Okay? So here you can see it is a simple polynomial equation in the derivative. So order, what is the order here? Highest order 2, 1, 3. So highest order is 3. And what is the power of highest order? It is 1. So degree will become 1. Yes? Now again, if you look at this example, you can see 1 plus dy by dx whole square to the power 3 by 2. And here it is 8 d square y upon dx square. Means again you have to remove this fractional power. Means what you have to do? Again you have to square on both sides. So square both sides. So what it will become? 1 plus dy upon dx whole square to the power. Square means this will make cube. 2 will get cancelled. 8 square is 64. And this is d square y upon dx square whole square. So now this is the simplified form, polynomial equation in derivative, and index are also positive. So what will be the order? So you can see highest order is 2 and degree. What is the power of highest order? It is also 2. So order is 2 and degree is also 2. Okay? Clear with order of a differential equation and degree of differential equation.